a really welcomed addition.
Well, an important piece in that Canberra United defensive lineup, a good mature head to get around the young girls. And at the other end of things, the aforementioned Serena Bolden, well, she comes to the Newcastle Jets. And what kind of impact do you think she might make this afternoon?
Top signing. She's going to complement the speed around her that this Newcastle Jets side has. She's a link forward. She plays with enormous passion and grit, and she's just a really exciting player.
Oh, exciting indeed. Great to see her back in the Liberty A-League this afternoon. Taking care of proceedings on the centre referee today is Caitlin Williams. She's assisted this afternoon by assistant referees in Lauren Hargrave and Delphina Shakespeare. And our fourth official for today is Nathan Shakespeare. Of course, as well, Emily Van Egmond, the Matilda. Well, she was given a warm reception on return to her hometown in Newcastle last week, but today she faces her former team in Canberra United, where she spent two seasons from 2009 to 2011. It's a warm afternoon here in Canberra at McKellar Park, and no doubt we'll see another great turnout by the Canberra faithfuls. It was a record-breaking crowd last time Canberra played here at McKellar Park. Just a few moments of pause before Caitlin Williams gets things underway at McKellar Park. One last check with her assistant referees, a look at the watch. And so right on 4 o'clock, Caitlin Williams gets things underway this afternoon. Today's meeting between these two sides, the 24th time in history that Canberra and Newcastle have come up against each other, and I'm going to say it is a fixture that Canberra have dominated in the past. Of those 23 previous meetings, it's Canberra who have won 17, Newcastle just the 3 wins and 3 draws between them. So it's a big afternoon. And Newcastle, well, we mentioned it, but they've had a couple of new inclusions. Emily Van Egmond, we know her quality. Serena Bolden and Leah. Newcastle have only ever beaten Canberra once here at McKellar Park. And how do you think they'll go about turning that stat around this afternoon?
Yeah, look, I think today could potentially be a different story. They're coming off the back end of a strong performance against Melbourne City. They've got good link play in some of their local players.
We'll come back to that in just a moment, because here is Michelle Heyman looking to get things underway for Canberra United. The ever-present Michelle Heyman finds the back of the net in her 3rd of the season and her 97th career goal. Well, that century, it looms tantalisingly close. Canberra have taken the lead.
And that's a really classy finish by Heyman. You can see she just steps in front of the defender there, so Chico has a decision to slow down or foul. Really classy finish, accurate in the bottom of the corner. Great start for Canberra United.
Well, it's a flying start for Canberra United. They love playing at McKellar Park, and Michelle Heyman, she loves scoring in front of a home crowd. A neat finish, a clinical one, really composed. And that is Michelle Heyman's 3rd goal of the season. As Newcastle, well, they are going to look for a quick response.
They are, and it's going to have to come just to make sure that they can shift a little bit of this momentum. We know what McKellar Park is like. It's a fortress. The Canberra crowd, the atmosphere, and how they get around this Canberra United group, it's not a place you want to go and go down a goal so early.
Well, Negos Popovic, Canberra United's coach, he will be happy with that start. A really good way to get this afternoon's fixture underway. And well, he spoke last week about, well, last fixture, should I say, that Canberra had about their opportunities and building and pulling all the pieces together. And, well, he'll be very pleased with that. Here's Lincoln. A little bit of pressure from Bolden. We know she applies that press really well. There's Bauman looking to drive through. A little nip at the heels, and that will be a free kick. Caitlin Williams quick to pull that one up. Well, Gary Van Egmond, he'll be less pleased with that start, and you can see frustration early on. What kind of response can his side produce? And here's a free kick for Newcastle. Van Egmond to take. She whips in a great ball into the box, and that's a good late run from Serena Bolden to meet the header.
Yeah, it's an excellent delivery by Emily Van Egmond there. It's whipped in with pace. The concerning thing for Canberra United is that Bolden is free in the box and she's actually able to challenge for that uncontested. Marking of plays in the box is going to have to be something that Canberra United are going to have to tidy up this week.
Well, we know the quality of someone like Van Egmond and the deliveries that she can produce. And when you've got the instinct of a striker like Serena Bolden looking to get on the end of them, well, that can be dangerous. But for now, Newcastle, they'll look to build. Ball driving forward, and it's Gooch finding a cross. Just swings that one. It's a little bit gusty at McKellar Park this afternoon. Oh, Popovich, he will be pleased with the start, but a real question now on what Canberra can continue to do in what was a really positive opening, well, minute really, the opening 60 seconds. Well, Sasha Grove, just one of two Canberra players named in your Young Matilda's squad. So we hold that thought. Serena Bolden looking for a response to the Newcastle Jets. She slots it on easily into the back of the net. Looking for the crowd for support, but she won't get much here in Canberra. It's a brilliant finish from Bolden. She's welcomed herself back to the Liberty A-League.
It's an excellent finish by Bolden, and we touched on at the start her link play, but also her ability to make forward runs in behind, and probably something that we saw throughout the World Cup campaign and now is that she's actually a little bit more clinical. She created several chances last season, but just wasn't as clinical as we're seeing right now.
It's a top finish from Bolden. Her second in the Liberty A-League, but of course her first of this year, this season, a new shirt with the Newcastle Jets. She appeared 10 times last year for the Western Sydney Wanderers and scored the one goal. But to get off to that kind of start with Newcastle...
Yeah, it's a great start. And we look at Serena Bolden, we look at her history. So she's a player who's already played in our Liberty A-League as an international. She's been to a World Cup. She's got grit, determination. She really suits this Newcastle Jets playing style. Wonderful addition.
And of course, she scored the first ever goal for the Philippines in a historic win over New Zealand at the World Cup. And we see that quality she's brought immediately to this Jets side. And when you've got the delivery of the likes of Van Egmond, but to Cass Davis in the midfield for the Jets, and Lara Gooch, as I was mentioning, a young Matilda as well, really good quality.
Excellent quality, and you've touched on the young Matildas that are in this group and the other younger players. The balance between having more experienced players, top internationals, and those youth is something that I think Gary Van Egmond at the moment is getting right.
Well, just before that goal, we spoke about the kind of response we'd see from Newcastle, and, well, they've answered that question loudly. Van Egmond couldn't have asked for much better of a response to that, and here's Newcastle looking for a second, driving in, and the offside flag has gone off. But once more, Serena Bolden is just testing, proving her quality.
Ah, she is. She's an absolute pest. She's in and around the box. A little bit more composure there where she leans over that. And then, of course, obviously the component of staying onside initially. We're going to see her getting good goal-scoring positions throughout this match.
Bowman, she'll connect with Bolden, but the pass is a little short. Bolden to Bauman, the Swiss international, and can roll out through Copas Brown. Of course, Libby Copas Brown for the Newcastle Jets, returning to the league this year, having spent time over with Lewis FC in the UK. No stranger to the A-League. having played previously at both Newcastle and the Western Sydney Wanderers?
She certainly isn't. And again, I think that's just another asset and positive dimension that Gary Van Egmond has brought to this Newcastle side. You're putting players together who have some continuity. So they've played together through the youth ranks in Newcastle. Potentially some of them have gone overseas and got those experiences. And now they're back together and looking to gel.
Lovely ball through from Van Egmond, and it's Bauman who looks to get on the end of it. Lincoln's out to claim really well. Strong hands from the young goalkeeper. But twice in as many minutes, Newcastle are looking really threatening.
They are, and that's an excellent little well-weighted pass by Van Egmond. When we can see Bauman, she's going to be a threat in the attack. Despite taking up a left fullback position, she does play very high and get in good goal-scoring positions for Newcastle.
She's been a great addition to this Newcastle Jets side, Lorena Bauman. 26 years of age. Most recently played a bit of football in Iceland, but has good international experience and around a younger group, bringing good leadership to the side.
Absolutely, and you can just see in terms of the Newcastle Jets build-up, she does position herself a little bit higher in between lines, almost keeps a back three intact for Newcastle with Chico, Karapetis and Pryor, and it just gives her that freedom to get forward.
Well, that's a good long searching ball over the top, and Lauren Allen looks to make something of it, but only as far as Chloe Lincoln. Well, Lincoln, the 18-year-old, named in the young Matilda squad to travel to China tomorrow, I believe, Leah.
Yes, we jet off tomorrow and looking forward to joining the squad and having everybody arrive early tomorrow morning. Good to go.
Well, some really great young talent across both of these teams that are joining on that trip. For Canberra, it's Sasha Grove and Chloe Lincoln. And for the Newcastle Jets, four players named to that young Matilda squad in Chico, Karapetis, Gooch and Hammond. Hammond not in today's match day squad. There is Cass Davis, who long-standing legend in the game and in Newcastle, of course, but will come and stick with play for the time being. Flannery looks to hook across in, but it's swept out by Tash Pryor, who too once wore the green shirt. Indeed. Tash Pryor being put to work now up against Heyman. Davis with some clean-up duties. And Newcastle can relieve a bit of pressure. But it was Tash Pryor. She was a former Canberra United player in season 2018-19. Spent a bit of time both at Sydney FC and now Newcastle. And her and goalkeeper Izzy Nino, well, they're the only two players for the Jets to have played all minutes so far.
And what a great start to the season Natasha Pryor is having. She's getting a little bit of consistency in terms of an injury-free run, and we saw it throughout the New South Wales NPL competition as well when she's played in that league. Fit Natasha Pryor with some consistency is quite a good player.
Yeah, she's quality at the back for Newcastle. Really strong, great in the air. Up against her former team today. It was just three appearances she had for Canberra United before she was sidelined with a long-term concussion, actually, that put her out. But she's in really good form back this year in the gold, is Tash Pryor. Well, it's been an action-packed opening few minutes. As Caitlin Williams just comes to have a chat, a quick check-in on Nikki Flannery. Looks as though she might have had a bit of a coming together there with Claudia Chico.
Yeah, just a little bit of a two-handed push in the back by Claudia Chico. Probably a little bit unnecessary there. We know that those two are great mates, given that they played NPL with Apia Leichhardt, so I'm sure no malice.
Well, that ball has found its way into the back of the net against the run of play. A quickly taken free kick, lobbed over the top. It's caught Chloe Lincoln off her line. And we talk about responses. We talk about turning things around. Newcastle Jets are flying.
They are, and you can see the leadership of Emily Van Egmond there. Obviously, Newcastle have just scored, and she's bringing players in, and she's addressing them now and instructing them to be switched on. A quick restart that's caught Canberra United out with their line being a little bit high, and Chloe Lincoln is just a little bit too high off her own line there, and EVE takes the opportunity.
Well, it was a really cleverly, quickly taken free kick from Cass Davis Smart. And Emily Van Egmond, her second goal in as many games. Well, we know she's here on a four-game guest stint for Newcastle. And if you're scoring a goal a game, that's a pretty good pickup.
It certainly is. And what will be key after the departure of EVE for this Jets side is that they continue with the positive momentum and continue to apply the learnings from her time in with them.
Well, it will be Van Egmond to... gets to take this free kick here. Bertolizio deemed to have fouled Serena Bolden as Van Egmond just tries to edge a few inches forward on that ball. But we know she's got a great set-piece delivery. So let's see what she can make of this one. Van Egmond. Long, sweeping pass. Top of the 18-yard box, it's headed away. Stanich Floody. And Christofferson looks to break through beyond Chico. Wins her side a throw.
And I think that's going to be an outlet for this Canberra United side. Christofferson is extremely quick. Flannery on the other side is rapid as well. I think in transition, they potentially can expose this Newcastle Jets side, especially if Bowman is caught too high.
But dealing with a bit of pressure at the other end of things is Canberra United's defence. Emma Ilioski having to clean up well. Of course, wonderful Canberra product is Emma Ilioski. The 20-year-old, it's her fourth season in the green. Of course, spent a bit of time with the young Matildas, junior Matildas setups. A really great club player. Well, Chloe Lincoln's forced to clear. It's a little bit shallow. Here's Ilioski again with close pressure from Van Egmond, who's finding herself pretty high up the field this afternoon. Ilioski, she opts just to relieve a bit of pressure, but it's won by Newcastle again, knotted on by Bolden. Canberra struggling to clear here as Bowman rolls back out. Tries to find Copas Brown inside, and that's well worked. That's a solid challenge from Bertolizio, and Bowman, who is streaming forward, is fouled.
And we saw this kind of intensity out of the Newcastle Jets against Melbourne City. So it's a high press. They're on the front foot. You can see Copas Brown in there just able to nip in front and win things from their midfielders. In terms of the challenge by Bertolizio, she's just got to stay low, stay side on, and show Bowman towards the sideline there.
Oh, you mentioned it, Leah. Bowman loves to get forward, and we can see that already. It's causing a few problems just for the space exposed at Canberra United's defensive line. And yet again, it will be Van Egmond who looks to swing this set piece in. Van Egmond, nice ball. Equally good clearing header, and it's hooked away by Canberra, but they are really struggling to relieve the pressure that's been applied so well by Newcastle Jets. Now a rare touch for Izzy Nino, the American who's come in between the sticks for Newcastle this season. We have to say she's been the quieter of the two goalkeepers so far, has Izzy Nino, the 24-year-old. There's another look at what was a really well-taken lob from Van Egmond. Well, we know she's a technician, and those kind of moments are her bread and butter. Clough with a long, searching ball. Finds the speed and the pace of Christofferson, who, as you mentioned, she is rapid. Bowman looking to close down. Christofferson's done well. Yep, there was a question asked there of not only the Canberra players, but the Canberra fans that you can hear coming through strong, and Christofferson makes herself a nuisance.
And I think it's a fair call by the referee in this moment. Christofferson's facing backwards. So again, there's really no need for Bowman to even try and win that challenge. Just hold her up, just delay, and then allow your midfielders to recover and possibly put in a challenge there.
Now what produces a good opportunity for Canberra to try and level things up, and it will be Mary Stanich-Floody standing over this free kick. The 17-year-old, well, she was key in Canberra's last fixture, and that one's a little narrow, going for the near post herself.
Yeah, it does appear that Stanich-Floody there has gone for the shot. Potentially, I think, she opts to deliver there. When you've got players like Michelle Heyman in and around that central goal zone, we know they're a threat.
Certainly when you've got the likes of Michelle Heyman lurking, but for the time being, it's Newcastle who are looking the more threatening.
They certainly are, and the task for Canberra United now is, can they get their playmakers, can they get their central midfielders on the ball facing forward and just retain a little bit more possession? They're certainly pinned into this back third, and it's not a place that you want to spend a lot of time.
Well, down to the other end of things, and it will be Christofferson who gives chase. She's got company close by. Newcastle had to do some backtracking of their own. Claudia Chico, well, she's really established herself as a starting member in this Newcastle Jets side. A really talented, young, fast player.
She certainly has. She's a born and bred Sydney girl. She moved to Wellington, obviously, for some game time opportunities, which came a little bit to fruition, didn't. She's moved on to the Newcastle Jets, where she's a starter every week.
Well, Canberra, they look to make something of this. Michelle Heyman, well, you mentioned just moments earlier, a lurking Michelle Heyman is a dangerous prospect. And it's Sasha Grove, who's up to defensive duties. Clough helps on. Grove, she can drive into space. Looks for the run of Milivojevic. She's been prolific. Lovely turn from Milivojevic. Weaves over the top of the ball, and that has scraped the top of the net. Those moments, she can be so dangerous.
She certainly can, and it's taken 20 or so minutes, but that's the quality of Vesna Milivojevic. She's able to turn on a dime, she's both footed, she keeps the ball between her feet. Excellent technical player. And as you can see, the danger of Heyman on set pieces. She can't be unmarked in the box and free like we've just seen.
Just moments, and Milivojevic, although perhaps a quiet start, you just can't sleep on a player like that. She's got such quality, and she's really made herself known on this stage, both this season and last, as she'll stand over the top of this corner. Has Stanich-Floody as a short option, but looks to swing in. It's a well-driven ball, good header away. Sasha Grove will look for the re-entry, and Nino, a little awkward on the claim, but looks to be safely in the hands of Izzy Nino. Or Jets, they can drive forward. Lauren Allen, nice little connecting ball to Copus Brown. Trying to find the run of Bowman. Flannery with a bit of work to do, had Bowman hot on her tail. Well, it's Nikki Flannery's 80th appearance this afternoon in the Liberty A-League. And at 24 years old, she's really become a bit of an experienced campaigner in this league.
She certainly has, and it's just another example of a player you'd like to see get a little bit of consistency and good form and remain injury-free. She's explosive, she's exciting. She can play either flank, left or right, and I'm hoping to see Nikki really have a good A-League season with some consistency.
Well, she too, Nikki Flannery, up against her former side in Newcastle today. She had a season with the Jets in 2019. 2020. Of course, did her ACL too in Matilda's training program and has had to return from that. But looks to be fit and firing this year for Canberra. But for now, it's Newcastle. Van Egmond nods down to Copas Brown. She has a bit of space. Grove has read that well. Christofferson looks to stride out into space. Sizes up her opposition, but it's a good overlapping run from Grove. Relentless energy does Sasha Grove. Trying to find a centering cross in Heyman, but that's headed well by Pryor. A bit of a scuffed clearance from Newcastle. Haven't quite got that one away cleanly. Van Egmond looks to run into space, but Clough is there to tidy up. And it feels like for the first time in this opening half, perhaps just that initial energy is just starting to slow in this game. It was really quite a flurry of a first 15 minutes.
Yeah, there's definitely been a drop, and I think that's due to the transitional nature where there's often repeat sprint efforts by both sides. It becomes fatiguing. So for both Canberra United and Newcastle Jets, they're going to be looking to get the ball down, keep it for longer periods of time, and just take a bit of the punch out of that constant transition.
Well, it's three goals in the opening 15 minutes, and Sasha Grove is looking for an equaliser for Canberra. Nice ball into the middle of the box. It's Heyman, swings a boot through it. Milivojevic had a chance moments earlier. Canberra asking for a corner, but Sasha Grove has done really well there to create for the girls in green.
Oh, that's an excellent front third decision by Grove. She drives towards the end line. She's got good intent. You see she gets her head up. She picks out a player with a well-weighted pass. Excellent wide area action by Grove. In terms of Heyman, she just needs to lean over it and pick her spot there with the finish.
Must say too, a classy save from Isabel Nino in goal for the Newcastle Jets. Came out, made herself really big. Milivojevic, well, she was there hunting for that cross in, as you mentioned, what was a really good driving run from Sasha Grove. Here's Clough. All the way back to Lincoln. She has time to look up, but a bit of pressure from Van Egmond. Grove can nod on. Stanage Fuddy. Nice little 1-2 with Grove. Better from Canberra. Looking for the ball through. Stanage Fuddy doesn't quite meet the intended outcome. Kara Peters. Well, that pass is falling a little awkwardly, and Bauman looks to innovate an answer to that, but it's dropped back to Tash Pryor. And Van Egmond, who's dropped a little deeper. And she can turn and face forward. Lovely ball through to Lara Gooch. Ilioski close for company, but Gooch, she's a tricky customer. Challenge just on the edge of the box. Gooch is still alive. It's taken a bit of a deflection, and that will be a Newcastle Jets corner. Well, we saw the connection last week with Van Egmond and Gooch. Van Egmond really seemingly the key to unlock some great moments for the youngster in Lara Gooch, and didn't she thrive under that?
Oh, she absolutely did. It's almost like a master and apprentice scenario up there at the moment. We've got the what's come through the Newcastle Jets ranks along with what is coming. So it's a really exciting combination and great to see them starting to connect and on the same page again today.
Van Egmond corner into the box, nodded away from Canberra. That's a lovely strike back through. Didn't quite have the leverage that it first looked to off the boot, but it was Gooch getting on the end of that one. Nice distribution from Lincoln. Canberra had the three corners to the Newcastle, just the one. There's Chloe Lincoln. She's looking to get her side up. Just looking for an option, really. A green shirt, a bit of an outlet. It's Canberra look to pick apart a well-organised Jets shape. And Cara Peters, the 18-year-old, she's been impressive coming into this Newcastle Jets side this year, Leah.
She certainly has. And the action we just saw where she drives to commit that pressing line and then is able to play a little reverse pass and find a central midfielder. This is a ball-playing centre-back. This is an 18-year-old who's comfortable. And you can just see the delivery from Van Egmen and the numbers forward and the importance of picking up that second phase where Gooch is able to get onto it and just a little bit underpowered with that effort.
Nice little round the corner from Van Egmond. Bolden looks to swing in across first time and Lincoln can easily collect. And again, just looking for a green shirt, but the high line of Newcastle Jets deny the opportunity.
Yeah, and it's an extremely aggressive line, which means there's going to be space in behind, which Canberra United now have to try and find players just higher up the pitch if they're going to commit that many forward.
Well, it's a lovely touch from Michelle Heyman, but had a pocket picked from Tash Pryor and Lauren Allen. She can drive forward. Little glancing look up. It's a lovely delivery. Really great defending. Cannon Clough had to be alert to the danger. The thumbs up from Van Egmond says it all.
Yeah, excellent defending by Kennan Clough. She's able to recover the right side of Van Egmen, so she's in front. Laura Allen gets her head up and she's picking out Van Egmen, and Clough is just there to take care of it. Potentially redirects it with her left foot, so it goes out for a throw-in, not a corner, but much better alternative than at finding Emily Van Egmen in the six-yard box.
Well, Van Egmond again will deliver on the corner. Lovely shape on the ball, but great hands from Lincoln, who plucks that from the sky.
Yeah, excellent by Lincoln. She's brave. She's on the front foot. She comes out, and that's easy pickings for her.
She's got great height, great stature, does Chloe Lincoln. Just 18 years old, already towering over 6 foot. Really good shape for the young goalkeeper. Oh, that is a serious challenge from Tegan Bertolicio, and she'll drive forward. Tries to find an outlet through Heyman. It's Milivojevic who can pick up. And that ball will fall just a little shallow. Easy work for Izzy Nino. Well, the American shot stopper looking to play quickly. Didn't have an option. A white shirt close by. Instead, she'll opt for the long ball and try and find an outlet. Copas Brown switches out, searching for Lauren Allen, but that one's got a little bit too much on it. It'll be a Canberra throw. Grove to take, but only as far as a white shirt of Newcastle in their away strip today. Stanich Valley, she'll help on. Christofferson looking to tear through. It's well managed by Pryor. And again, Nino will just kick for distance. Grove trying to find an outlet, but it's well worked by Lauren Allen, who's worked her side a throw. So as we tick over the halfway mark of this first 45 minutes, it really was a flurry of those opening 15 minutes. It's Michelle Heyman who got things underway in just the second minute, closely followed by a good response from Serena Bolden in the fifth, and who else but Emily Van Egmond in the 13th minute, and it's closed up a little since then. As mentioned, it's just the one time that Newcastle have beaten Canberra at McKellar Park. It's not a happy stomping ground for the Jets coming to visit Canberra United. And the last time these two teams faced each other, late last season, February of this year, it was a 3-0 win to Canberra that day. Goal scorers Laura Hughes, Michelle Heyman and Grace Maher, two players no longer at Canberra United. And well, the last time Newcastle beat Canberra, that was back in November of 2018. 1-0 that day, and the goal scorer, well, none other than Courtney Vine. But for now, here is Sasha Grove driving forward again, as she has done really well this afternoon. Canberra searching for an option into the middle of the box. Nice glancing header from Heyman. Had Flannery close behind. Well worked from Nino through to Bolden. She looks for the run of Van Egmond, but Clough is alert to the danger.
And you can just see Sasha Grove, the composure and the ability for Milivojevic to make a little overlapping run there and get on the ball. In terms of the delivery, excellent delivery. Flannery's just inside that far post a little bit too early. Needs to time her run a little bit better, and she'd be in a better position in the six-yard box to score.
Davis looks to help on for Allen. Newcastle throw with Claudia Chico, and they'll look for a way to build up. Chico finds Allen and Gooch. She can turn and face ball into the box. It was a nice ball too. Van Egmond relatively unmarked. Lincoln was well positioned, and Van Egmond, well, she's got to get a little talking to here.
And you can just see Lara Gooch there. She's able to turn, face forward, and pick out Van Egmond, who she's in a good goal-scoring position. Again, timing of her run, she's in a little bit early, so she's almost having to backtrack to make contact there. Timing improved would help with a better contact.
Well, Stanich Buddy, she can drive into space, finds Michelle Heyman through the line. Heyman can shape up, size up. It's Flannery trying to find the run into the box. Milivojevic, and what was a brilliant tackle. Newcastle Jets player Libby Copus-Brown flying through to deny the shot.
Yeah, and we certainly hate to see Copus-Brown down in this moment on the back end of some really brave defending in this 18-yard box. She's made the recovery run from midfield. She's getting herself in a position where she's just got a foot in and able to stop Milivojevic there from having a clear shot on goal.
Oh, desperation defending. A really great challenge from Copus-Brown. It looked as though she caught that one on the ankle, the outstretched ankle, as she looked to stop that cross. But what was a really great build-up from Canberra. Stanich Floody, lovely ball through the line to Michelle Heyman. Just a little nick seemed to put off the run of both Bauman and Flannery coming into the box.
Yeah. Excellent delivery by Stanich Floody, and Newcastle Jets are going to have to be aware of midfielders making forward runs, and we've touched on the quality of Flannery. Herself and Milivojevic can't be left unmarked in that far post zone. It's a trend now that this Canberra United side are building up more so through this left side and looking to deliver to the right.
Well, Milivojevic with her back to goal here, trying to make something, and makes as much as a corner. It'll be a good opportunity for Canberra to shape up, get some good numbers in the box, and Newcastle, as his first half just ticks closer away, they'll be wanting to hold on to this lead going into the break. I see the towering height of Izzy Nino, the American goalkeeper for Newcastle, and Stanich Fuddy with two arms in the air, but Caitlin Williams is having a quick word. Christofferson closely marshalled right in the goal mouth. Stanich Fuddy, corner into the box. Good, strong hands up by the goalkeeper.
And Nino's done really well there. She's got her own teammate and Canberra United player between her and the ball, and she's come out above both of them easily collecting.
Good strong hands, but she'll be disappointed with the distribution. The ball was swept into a dangerous part of the box, but it was a strong take.
Yeah, it was an excellent take, and then the next piece of it is keeping the ball from that.
Good to see Copus Brown back on the field. Just switching the point of attack out to Lauren Allen. Well, we know she is rapid too. Sizes up Grove. Finds a bit of support. And the ball's crossed in to the centre of the park. It's fallen kindly to Bolden. He gets a boot through it. But Alicio was there. And Bolden, she's frustrated at herself.
She is, but I think it's a tough angle for Bolden there. It's a good delivery by Gooch on a non-preferred foot, her left foot. Very difficult. Chloe Lincoln has that near post covered. There's pressure from Tegan Bertolisio.
It has resulted in another corner for Newcastle. Just a little push and shove in the middle there. As Van Egmond, she swings in a corner into the box. It's fallen to Milivojevic, who will look to stride out. Davis applies the pressure. And it's landed back with Grove. And Ilioski find Murray. Canberra look forward, searching for the run of Heyman. Good, strong shoulder. Michelle Heyman up against Tash Pryor. Two great physical players.
Yeah, definitely going to be a physical matchup between both these players. Excellent vision by Mary Stanich-Floody there. She sees that the line's a little bit higher. Natasha Pryor, in terms of her positioning, she's marking in front and she's actually in a good position to win the ball from Heyman there. Now it's just about having the physical capacity to make sure that she's able to stay on her feet and not get pushed around by Heyman.
Well, it's back at the other end of things, and Lauren Allen with some fanciful footwork looks to drive in, but Stanich-Floody has done well again. Bauman looks to hook across in. Little hand of apology. Davis can help on. Second ball through. Davis looks to get the strike away off the crossbar. It's still in play. Bolden back to Van Egmond. Again to Bauman. But the offside flag, rather, is a welcome sight to Canberra United, who were absorbing wave after wave there.
They certainly were, and that's an excellent strike by Cass Davis. Chloe Lincoln isn't able to get a hand to it there. It's come off the crossbar. And the concerning thing, though, is that there's a Newcastle Jets player there to pick the ball up straight away. This Canberra United side need to make sure that they're picking up second phase in and around this box.
Well, if there's one thing we know about Cass Davis is that she only scores spectacular goals, and that one would have been her third, denied only by the crossbar. It's Van Egmond, cheeky nutmeg. She gets the eyes up, cross into the box. Grove is there, it's fallen to Copus Brown. Can't quite get the ball out from her feet. Tegan Bertolisio, a 17-year-old, she's had a busy afternoon, and this is another look at the strike from Cass Davis.
Yeah, it's a fantastic strike by Davis. She just leans slightly a little bit too far back. If she leans over that, that's going to dip down. In saying that, difficult technique from the top of the 18-yard box to get that up and over.
Pryor, well, she's happy to drop it all the way back to Izzy Nino and build up again. Here's Davis. Pryor searches out wide for Allen, but that pass has gone awry. Grove. All the way back to Lincoln. Canberra happy to concede a little territory as this first half just ticks away. Grove. She's been busy this afternoon. Headed away well by Kara Peters. Here's Murray. Round the corner from Heyman. Lovely little flick on. Milivojevic looks to return the favour. Jets set well. Here's Grove again. It's been an energetic half from her. Christofferson. Marshalled well at the back by Newcastle. Van Egmond looks around the corner, helps a lovely ball through. Here's Lara Gooch. Serena Bolden's in space if she can get the ball in early, but it's not quite the delivery she needed to find Bolden.
No, it isn't. And I think in terms of Lara Gooch there, I think she actually just needs to put her foot on the ball, go 1v1 with Ilioski and back yourself to potentially beat her or win a corner.
And now defending at the other end, and Christofferson's done really well, has a little glancing look up. Good recovery defence there by Claudia Chico. Canberra asking for a corner. Well, you can hear what the Canberra faithful crowd think about that one. Nino looks to go long. Here's Grove again. Grove. Tidy turn. Allen working hard. That ball not quite where she wanted it to go. Nino will just slow things down as this first half ticks away. Bauman. In those high positions we've seen her work into this first half. Nice little interception from Flannery, but Copus Brown has still done well to chase down. Last ditch challenge from Holly Murray had to be as well. Well, just before the halftime whistle, Van Egmond, she'll line up for another corner. Well, her deliveries so far have been exceptional. Into the sun, facing for Chloe Lincoln, and Van Egmond opts for the short corner. Here's Bauman, little eyes up. Ball into the far post. It's a good, strong challenge from Chloe Lincoln. Great goalkeeping.
Yeah, Chloe Lincoln does really well there to get off her line and then obviously take that over the head of Bolden, and it's a right idea for a quick release here. Excellent decision by the young goalkeeper.
Well, it will be 3 minutes of stoppage time here at McKellar Park. As the time ticks away, and what was a flurry of a first half start for both sides, knotted on here from Michelle Heyman and cleared well by Pryor. Christofferson, or she'll chase down, the ball is still in. Looks to find Heyman short, but the pass is a little skinny. But Grove, well, she's picked up just as quickly as giving that one away, but it's back with Canberra. Standage play around the corner. Lovely ball. Milivojevic driving in on her left foot. Leans back just slightly, and that one's always rising.
And that is a really clever no-look pass by Stenich Floody, and it's exactly what this Canberra side needs more of, finding Milivojevic, whether she's making a forward run, whether she's receiving it in between lines, and it comes down to the quality and the distribution that comes from the midfielders behind her, like we just saw.
Oh, it was a great ball through from the young Mary Stenich Floody, just 17 years old. She came across to Canberra this year from Sydney FC, where across two seasons, making 14 appearances. But we'll stay with play here with Canberra as Christofferson looks to nod on. But it's Chico who's cleared that well.
And just on Stenich Floody there, the youngster coming across, in the amount of game time that she's receiving, she's only going to grow from strength to strength this season.
Milivojevic looking to bundle her way through the box. Again, couldn't get the clean shot away that she would have liked, but certainly feels as though she's growing into this half. And well, we know how dangerous Vesna Milivojevic can be as well. As we tick into the last minute of stoppage time here at McKellar Park, and have another look at the quality of Milivojevic.
Yeah, look, she's a both-footed player, so she's able to receive it, change feet. She protects herself so well in that moment where she can get in between defenders. She's a class act in this front third.
Perhaps just one last foray forward for Canberra, but it's fallen short. Bit of an awkward back pass for Newcastle late in this first half as they look to play out of pressure. Nice run over the top of the ball, but runs out of real estate there. And Canberra, you think they'd see out the half with this throw. It's Grove. There is the half-time whistle from Caitlin Williams. What has been an entertaining first half encounter here at McKellar Park. It was Michelle Heyman who got scoring underway in the second minute, followed very closely by Serena Bolden in the fifth. Emily Van Egmond to put Newcastle Jets in the league. And at halftime here at McKellar Park, it's Canberra United 1, Newcastle Jets 2. And Leon, what has been an entertaining first half? Let's take a quick look back at the goals that got us underway. It was the one from Michelle Heyman in the second minute.
Clinical finish by Heyman. As I touched on, she steps in front of a defender. She picks her spot, side foot, and she hits the netting. Really classy finish.
With pressure from both angles as well, you've got to say, just demonstrating her quality on the ball. And that was exactly the reception that both Negos Popovic and the McKellar Park fans wanted to see. But how about this for a response from Newcastle?
Yeah, and at the other end we see similar clinical finish in Bolden. She steps in front of Bertolicio, so she has to slow down, which gives her the opportunity to pick which corner she wants to go with Chloe Lincoln coming out. Not much Chloe Lincoln can do there.
A very neat finish. And this one too from the Matilda, Emily Van Egmond against her former team.
Very much an Emily Van Egmond, thanks for coming. She sees the GK off her line. She's technically excellent. From that range, she's able to get it up and just dip over the young goalkeeper. Really nice finish by EVE.
Yeah, and that's the kind of quality she brings to the Liberty A-League. As we have a look at the halftime match stats, nothing too much separating the sides in the way of possession. There's been a lot of action at both ends as well.
It definitely has. It's probably more so a case of Canberra United's possession has been in their back third away from their goal. So they're obviously creating less clear-cut chances.
Well, no doubt a big 45 minutes coming up on the other side. But don't go anywhere. All the second half action is just after the break. Welcome back to the second half between Canberra United and the Newcastle Jets, where it's the Jets shading the lead 2-1 at the break after what was an entertaining first 45 minutes of football here at McKellar Park. There's a lively crowd spilling through the gates at McKellar and keen to get things underway for what will be a big 45 minutes of football coming up. And in very sad news, you'll see the black armband there, Canberra United players. Donning the armband in the very sad passing this week of Ellie Brash's dad, Paul, who sadly passed away. And Paul was a fierce advocate for women's sport, for Canberra United, for all of the Liberty A-League. And our thoughts at the moment are with Ellie, Marg and Alice in a very difficult time, but a lovely touch from the Canberra United girls. Well, Sasha Grove, she had a lively first 45 minutes for the girls in green. Everywhere across the pitch she was, getting up and down that flank, as it's Canberra who are set up, ready to go. Last instructions, Holly Murray. Quick chat with Emma Ilioski, and it's the Newcastle Jets who break their huddle and jog into position. No changes yet from what we can see on either side. But a warm afternoon in Canberra. Just the one time in competition history have Newcastle beaten Canberra at McKellar Park, and only three times ever across 24 encounters. Should the result remain today, as Caitlin Williams gets this second half underway, it would be just the fourth time Newcastle have beaten Canberra United in the history of the competition. So it's a big 45 minutes coming up. Leah Blaney, what do you suggest that the conversation at halftime was between the two sides?
Look, I think in terms of Gary Van Egmond's change rooms, he'd be talking to his Newcastle Jets players around just a little bit more care and consistency with their final passes. I think they've been off the mark a few times, and some of the decision-making there where they can be creating greater opportunities by picking out the right player or just putting a little bit more appropriate weight. Things are being overhit a little bit. In terms of Canberra United, they have to break this Newcastle Jets pressure. They've been pinned in for most part of the game in that back third. It's about getting their midfielders like Stanich Floody on the ball facing forward. Whenever that kid had the ball in the first half, it looked like something was going to happen.
Oh, she looked excellent in the first half for Canberra United, and Tash Pryor is called into action early for the Jets. Of heavy leg strapping on that right quad. As Izzy Nino stares into the sun for the next 45 minutes. Here's a throw from Canberra, helped around the corner from Heyman. Milivojevic looks to get a strike away, but it was Stanich Fuddy who came through in the end, finding herself a little higher up the field.
And I think that suits Stanich Floody. If he can play Holly Murray in a little bit of a deeper role, who we know at her time during the NPL Victoria, she's played as a centre-back or utilised as a six. We can see Stanich Floody and Milivojevic looking to combine closer to goal.
Well, they certainly had some good combinations in their final third, but at the other end of things, it's Casta Davis trying to push forward for the Newcastle Jets, but that pass a little too heavy. Chloe Lincoln, she'll look to get things underway for Canberra, but continues to be a high line for Newcastle, helped on well by Heyman. Flannery can run into space. Chico, great strength shown on the ball. Caitlin Williams has a little think about it, pauses, and then does award the foul. Chico looking a little bit confused about that one.
Yeah, and look, we'll watch the replay. You see Flannery makes the initial contact where she's grabbing Chico's arm. I actually think it's great strength and good defending by young Claudio Chico. In saying that, the street smarts of Flannery to not stay on her feet in a 50-50 call where she is a little bit off balance shows her maturity as well.
Well, nonetheless, it's led to a free kick in what is a really dangerous part of the field for Canberra United. Izzy Nino just organising her wall. And it's two Canberra players standing over the ball in both Mary Stanich Floody and Vesna Milivojevic. And it looks like the youngster has won out on this occasion. Stanich Floody to take. Strikes through into the wall. Heyman looks to follow up. Swept away. Newcastle Jets relieve the pressure, but only for a moment as Ilioski looks to help it back into the danger zone. A little too hefty in the back there from Christofferson. And Newcastle can take a breath and reset. Well, driving forward at the other end, Newcastle will look to make the most of this. A little nip at the heels there, and Benalicio gives away the free kick. Claudia Chico was indeed awarded a yellow card for that challenge on Flannery. There's a contact in the back from Christofferson.
And interesting to see if Emily Van Egmond opts to try and shoot here or potentially find targets like Natasha Pryor. Given the area of the pitch, they're treating it somewhat like a corner in terms of their setup.
Well, we certainly know she has the range. The Matilda, Emily Van Egmond, she's gone for the near post. Lincoln, to her credit, had it covered. As the clouds just start to roll in here at McKellar Park. Still a warm afternoon here in Canberra. But perhaps a little reprieve as the afternoon wears on.
Yeah, and you can see the smarts of Van Egmond possibly trying to catch Chloe Lincoln out there, but the youngster was all over covering that near post.
Well, Chico down the other end of things now. She has a throw for her side. Finds Bolden. Looking for support, Serena Bolden. Back to Chico. Good touch, affords her a bit of time and space. Karapetis almost gets herself in trouble, but finds an outlet in Pryor. Chico again. Allen. Good pressure from Grove. Davis is dispossessed. Murray can help on. Heyman will give chase, but Pryor is there. Nino too, off her line well. Good clearing kick.
Yeah, and just the goalkeeper Nino's there, proactive positioning. Because she is higher, she's outside her box, she's easily able to sweep up that.
Clough into the feet of Van Egmond. Clears really as far as Karapetis, who look to return it over the top for Gooch. Bertolicio, early ball in from Gooch. Easy take-ins for Chloe Lincoln.
And those are the front third decisions I touched on at the start of the half, Grace. Newcastle have to be better with this final pass. Again, Lara Gooch, take on your defender there. Go 1v1. Look to potentially beat her or draw a foul or a cross or cut back closer to goal.
Well, it's a little helter-skelter in these opening few minutes. Both sides, I have to say, giving up possession a little loosely. There will be a Canberra throw. Plenty of options off the bench today for both sides. Of course, Canberra United. Well, Alex McKenzie, she started all games prior to this today for Canberra. Today on the bench, an option in defence for Negos Popovic's side. Ruby Nathan too. The New Zealander, she's a good attacking option off the bench. Devon Jackson, Hannah McNulty. It's a little shallow pass there from Ilioski. But a good touch from Lincoln relieves the pressure. And two for Gary Van Egmond's side. Josie Wilson, Mindy Barbieri, of course we know her quality. Alex Hunt, a defensive option off the bench. And Sophie Hoban, who came to the bench today for Serena Bolden's inclusion, back in the side. And of course, Kiara Roche, the second goalkeeper. And I imagine as the afternoon wears on, we'll perhaps see a change fairly soon.
I think we will, Grace. Obviously, we haven't seen either coach go to the bench, but you've got Mick Nolte, who's a proven goal scorer in the New South Wales NPL. You've got Ruby Nathan, who's been a real surprise packet and doing very well in the Liberty A-League. And on the other side, you've got the cleverness of Melinda Barbieri. All could be great additions to this match.
Newcastle just looking to extend their lead a bit. But Holly Murray has found a nice outlet through Heyman. Heyman can face forward. Good pressure from Copas Brown. Heyman's done well to keep possession. Flannery under pressure. She concedes a bit of territory. It's Grove. Now Ilioski. Ball through to Stanage Floody. Little tricky one. Milivojevic, she pinches up a bit higher for Canberra. But still, Newcastle can play out. Chico looking for an answer. Pressure applied from Milivojevic. Claudia Chico just looking up, not finding a Newcastle shirt, needing a little bit more in the way of support from her teammates.
Yeah, I think definitely support. And you can hear Gary Van Egmond on the sideline telling her to dribble and try and take her space there. Just a little bit more positivity and she could have broken that pressure, as we saw on the other side just then with Zoe Karapetis.
Yeah, lovely touch forward from Karapetis. That's a good ball through to Lara Gooch. She glances up, has Clough for company. At the top of the box, Copas Brown is in good space. Gooch is relentless here. Just trying to afford herself a little bit of room. Hooks a nice cross in, but a little narrow. Finds the hands of Chloe Lincoln and not too much else. Heyman comes deep to pick up the ball from Canberra's defence. Ilioski, who seems to be dropping in a little deeper in that defensive line.
And you can just see the good defending by Ken and Clough there initially, just to stay on her feet. And the decision from Gooch to deliver, I've touched on it. I think she needs to be a little bit more patient. The Canberra United defence is set and organised in that back third area. Look to combine and possibly win a corner there.
Well, Canberra, they go all the way back to Lincoln in goal and again to Ilioski. Heyman, she looks to connect with Grove, but the pass a little shallow. Bouncing ball over the top. Chico, she'll go back to Nino. Not the most convincing clearance from Nino, but it has fallen kindly to Van Egmond. Nice early play. Serena Bolden looks to chase on, but Clough is positioned well. I think it's the offside flag that has gone up. And we will get our first change of the afternoon. As both sides turn to the bench, it will be Alex McKenzie coming on for Tegan Bertolicio. And for Gary Van Egmond's side, Josie Wilson taking the place of Claudia Chico. What do you make of those changes to both sides, Leah?
Yeah, look, interesting substitutions that potentially indicate that both coaches are going to remain on the defensive a little bit, given that both have brought on defenders. Potentially does Wilson give Newcastle Jets a little bit more energy going forward from that right fullback position? We know she's quick. We know she's up and down. And Chico's had a strong shift of football in that position this half.
Indeed, she has. Claudia Chico off to China tomorrow with the young Matildas, nursing a yellow card in this game as well. Perhaps a strategic sub from Gary Van Egmond, but at the other end of things, it's another free kick for Canberra, and this time it will be Milivojevic to take. Well, two hands in the air from Milivojevic sends the signal to her team. Plenty of numbers setting up on the edge of the box in green shirts as to in the Newcastle white today. Milivojevic, she lines up her option and at the 11th hour is halted to proceedings from Caitlin Williams. She'll get another go. Vesna Milivojevic. Gets the strike away. She's gone for goal. It's taken a wicket deflection. And it's Vesna Milivojevic. A bit of Milivojevic magic in her fourth goal of the season. Well, she's taken matters into her own hands. And she squares things up for Canberra United. It's 2-2 here at MacKellar Park.
She certainly does, and we know this is true of Milivojevic. She's been a little bit lucky with the ball actually taking a deflection. In saying that, it's an excellent strike. It's hit it. It's whipped in with pace, and you can see what it means to Milivojevic to get on the score sheet.
Well, four goals, four games. Vesna Milivojevic can produce moments of magic like that. A much-needed goal for Canberra United. Yes, a fortuitous deflection it took. But she won't be complaining. The girls in green won't be complaining. And while you were mentioning just earlier, Leah, the substitutions we saw, Alex McKenzie came on for Tegan Bertolicio, and Josie Wilson, also a defender, coming on for Claudia Chico. Two defensive options, and now perhaps both coaches looking down at their benches thinking, well, what can we do to separate this game in the way of attacking outlets?
Yeah, and we've touched on Melinda Barbieri as a possible decision. You bring Alex Hung on and she's going to bring a calmness but also be such a threat on set pieces for the Newcastle Jets. So there's definitely options there. We saw the quality of Sophie Hoban starting last week for the Jets. On the other side with Canberra United, Ruby Nathan, again, what a nice surprise she's been in this Liberty A-League and a well-deserved call-up to the New Zealand Football Ferns.
Well, it's a big 30 minutes coming up for both sides. Oh, Lincoln, just having a little laugh with the assistant referee for what was an offside call. And plenty of football to be played here. Only three draws ever in the history of the competition between these two teams. And plenty on the line to play for this afternoon. That's a great ball over the top. Early delivery. Serena Bolden looking for her second of the day. It's a cheeky little lob, and it is in the back of the net. What a response. Two times, Serena Bolden. Welcome back to the Liberty A-League.
And that's a really clever little finish by Serena Bolden. As you can see, the Canberra United line just caught out too high there. And Bolden's able to sneak in off the shoulder of Emma Ilioski there. And just a classy finish to chip Chloe Lincoln from that range.
Well, Canberra United's defence caught sleeping. A finish not too dissimilar to that of Van Egmond's in the first half. Silences the Canberra crowd. And that'll be a frustrating one for Nagos Popovic and the Canberra United girls, having just squared things up and drawn level. Just a lapse of concentration, but Canberra looking for a quick response themselves. Here's Milivojevic. Two, three, white shirts to beat. She whips in a nice cross. Difficult one for a green shirt to get the end of.
Very difficult one. For a Canberra United player to get on the end of there. We see that the Newcastle Jets, in terms of their recovery runs, they're in good positions to defend that goal zone.
And so Newcastle edged their way back into the lead.
And let's just reiterate what a great signing Serena Bolden has been. She's come in, it's her first game. She's an international signing, so we're going to expect quality. We're going to expect assists. We're going to expect goals from these players, and she's delivered today.
She has, playing with a certain level of instinct. Serena Bolden, the 27-year-old, well, we saw the kind of energy that she introduced last season at the Western Sydney Wanderers, and surprising somewhat that she wasn't re-signed immediately at the club.
Yeah, she's an absolute gem. She's passionate, she's gritty, and it appears that Gary Van Egmond's getting the best out of this player so far.
Well, she had a great World Cup with the Philippines women's national team. And we know that for Newcastle, well, Melina Ayres, who's a fantastic player in her own right, is still struggling with that hip flexor injury. And so Serena Bolden's been brought in as another option. And here's a good ball from Van Egmond. McKenzie called into action early on. But Bolden, well, we've seen this afternoon, 2 goals in her first game in a Newcastle shirt.
And I like those selection dilemmas for the Jets once Melina Ayres is back in.
Well, Canberra with a bit of work to do. It's hooked away by Ilioski. Just caught napping for that response from Serena Bolden. Exactly like the first half, how quickly Newcastle were able to turn things around. Looking to further their lead, Van Egmond. Well, she concedes a bit of territory. It's Karapetis. Now Wilson. Wilson, who's been fantastic in her previous appearances for Newcastle, coming on as a substitution and bringing really good energy. Heavy coming together. Lauren Allen will sweep this one in. Grove nods away. Van Egmond combines with Bolden. That one a little bit short. McKenzie just looks to relieve the pressure. That one's into the hands there of a Newcastle defender, and Milivojevic looks to take quickly. Vesna Milivojevic looking for the ball. You can hear the shouts of Popovic on the sideline asking for his players to be closer. That's a heavy challenge just outside the 18-yard box. A strong coming together. You saw Heyman go down immediately. She'll have to get checked here. Looks as though it could be a head knock. And it's Tash Pryor who's picked up a yellow card for the challenges. We have another look at this one.
Oh, yeah, and look, as you can see, both players have challenged for the ball. In terms of Natasha Pryor, she actually has to jump facing forward there. She jumps with her shoulder turned. I agree with the free kick, and I agree with the yellow card in that moment, Grace.
Yeah, and Heyman has well and truly come off worse for wear from this challenge. As we get another look at it, you can see the initial header from Bauman, and Heyman, you can see eyes for goal, and it's that side of the body you mentioned, Leo, and Pryor just knocking into Heyman.
Absolutely, and she's a strong, tough defender. There's no malice in that, but just any point that you're turning and jumping into an oncoming player like that, I think it's going to warrant her a free kick.
Well, we know coming up in a few weeks' time is Unite Round, early January from the 12th to the 14th. All games across the league taking place in Sydney. A wonderful, wonderful initiative. You can get down to see the Liberty A-League games as well as the Isuzu Ute A-League men's games, all based in Sydney. And a really wonderful occasion to see, well, all your favourite teams.
Oh, I can't wait. Accommodation is booked, Grace. It's the World Cup all over again. Back-to-back games, men's and women's football, all in the one location.
Now, you can get your tickets at ticketek.com.au and do get down to that one. It's going to be a fantastic showcase, a really great coming together of football in Australia, in almost like a mini festival of football across a weekend. It's going to be a great weekend. As Canberra fans look on as they wait to see if Michelle Heyman, their superstar striker, well, she scored a goal this afternoon in what is her 97th goal in the Liberty A-League. She's edging her way closer to that 100 mark. Ever so close, the 35-year-old. Well, we know she's not only the all-time leading goal scorer in the league, but also the all-time leading appearance maker. And here's that strike from Vesna Milivojevic. Took the deflection. And how about the celebration?
It's a fantastic celebration, and it's a great strike. Despite taking the deflection, if you don't shoot, you don't score. And Milivojevic has backed herself in this moment and has been rewarded.
Oh, it was quite the response from Serena Bolden, who has been a remarkable signing for Newcastle Jets and Gary Van Egmond.
Yeah, and that's a classy finish by Bolden. The youngster, Chloe Lincoln, possibly does she continue to come towards Bolden there and close that angle to make it a little bit tougher? you know, difficult and tough decision for the young goalkeeper. But essentially, this Canberra United back line need to make sure that they're not allowing Bolden to make forward runs in behind and be free.
Yeah, as we mentioned, Canberra defence caught napping there. It's great to see Michelle Heyman back to her feet after a heavy knock. You can see that bruising coming through on the left eye. And here is a free kick for Canberra United. It's Nikki Flannery to take. Doesn't quite have the whip or trajectory it needed. A little hand of apology as Izzy Nino will look to get things underway after a little break there. What was that yellow card to Tash Pryor for the challenge? And it does look as though Heyman's gone right down to the sheds.
Yeah, and if that's the case that she does stay off, interesting to see who comes on for Canberra United. We've touched on Ruby Nathan as being an option. You've also got, again, Hannah McNulty, who at the NPL level has proven to be a goal scorer, and a goal is what is needed right now for Canberra United.
I imagine we'll see in just a moment. Could well be Ruby Nathan giving the position, if it is indeed for Michelle Heyman, who looked to make her way straight to the change rooms. But for now, it's Newcastle. Good energy from Lauren Allen and well defended from Ilioski. Gary Van Egmond perhaps looking for a call from that one, as we do see that change confirmed. It will be Michelle Heyman making way, and Ruby Nathan, you mentioned earlier, the 18-year-old. Well, she's earned her first New Zealand Football Ferns call-up just this last week. And the Ferns in the international window coming up, set to face Colombia in South America next month. I'm looking to see what she can produce in the next 20 minutes. Centering ball in for Canberra, swept away well by Newcastle.
And just on Ruby Nathan, she's an exciting player. She's instinctive. She wants to be on the ball. She's going to be a presence in the box with her physical capability. I think she's a great addition.
Well, Christofferson looks to get away. Milivojevic on the spin. Nikki Flannery looks to guide that into the back of the net. But Izzy Nino's done really well. Come off her line, but play is still alive. Nice ball into the box. Sweeping delivery from Ilioski. A thumbs up from Milivojevic. Canberra looking like they have a bit about them.
Yeah, excellent use of a body by Christofferson. You can see Milivojevic if she's able to turn. And Izzy Nino does really well to get off her line there and make herself nice and big and it difficult for Nikki Flannery.
Well, it fell very kindly to Flannery. Izzy Nino made the right decision coming off her line, making herself big, closing the angle. McKenzie back to Lincoln. Bolden sending Lincoln one way. Long sweeping ball searching for Grove, and it's a solid coming together. Canberra have come away with the ball. Nathan connecting with Flannery. Karapetis looking to close down, and a resulting Canberra corner. No longer with the aerial presence of Michelle Heyman.
And the Jets need to be a little bit careful here. We have seen a shift in momentum where Canberra United are spending more time in the Jets' defensive half and, you know, conceding corners and half chances and those kind of things. They actually have to break this momentum up.
Stanich Floody, short ball in. Clough does well to pick up another chance for Stanich Floody. Stanich Floody again on the first time strike. Well, what a piece of technique that was. And what a performance the young player is having this afternoon.
Yeah, she's definitely having a great game. The initial delivery we see, she comes through and she picks up that second phase. She leans over it. She's just potentially got to just redirect that a little bit more towards the goalkeeper's left side, and we can see that on target.
Oh, it would have been a pretty special strike from Stanich Floody. And here she's trying to connect with Nathan. Bauman's done well to tidy up. Van Egmond looking for Gooch to release her into space, but Clough is positioned well. She can connect with Grove. Back to Clough. Clough looks long. Milivojevic. She'll pick up the free kick for that. She's asking for the yellow card. A neat little trick over the head.
Yeah, look, clever passage of play by Milivojevic. I'm not sure it warrants a yellow card by Karapetis, but a deserved free kick.
Grove just assessing options here for Canberra. She opts to go long, finds the feet of Nathan. That second touch a little long. Van Egmond can release Gooch. This partnership building really nicely between the two. Gooch looking for a white shirt. Puts on the afterburners. Dances from right foot to left. Can't get the shot away nor the cross. And Chloe Lincoln, well, she'll gladly see that into her hands. Grove again, driving into space. Slides the ball through to Milivojevic. Karapetis knocks out only as far as Nathan. The delivery didn't quite have a green shirt on the end of it. Davis finds the run of Bolden. Nice touch. Allen, she cuts inside. Good energy from Wilson as Allen looks for the first time cross, and Bolden looks to be creative on that one. She did have Van Egmond in the centre of the box.
And she could be the difference for the Newcastle Jets in these remaining minutes. Really, she actually shouldn't get to that ball first. But she anticipates. Canberra United a little bit casual, and Bolden's able to nip in there. Better technique execution and those kind of things from that moment, yes, but the signs are there that she's willing to take this game on her shoulders and try and close it out for Newcastle Jets.
Jets will pick up the goal kick, and it's going to be a free kick. Christofferson just a little reckless in the challenge on Bauman. And it will be another change for Newcastle this afternoon. Well, this is just a little knock here from Christofferson. Just a little clumsy in the back of Bauman. And it is indeed Sophie Hoban coming on this afternoon for Libby Copas-Brown, who is putting in a good shift for the day.
Yeah, she's put in an excellent shift. She's got an enormous work rate, and she's been a good link player in this midfield for Newcastle Jets, giving Van Egmond more freedom in that front third by being a bit of an anchor. Possibly a tactical change with one eye on next week. I believe she's on a yellow card, Grace.
Well, nonetheless, Hoban will be keen to impress in the next 14 minutes or so. Starting on the bench today, after losing a spot in the starting side, the introduction of the likes of Serena Bolden into this Newcastle Jets side. So a big 15 minutes for Sophie Hoban, the 22-year-old. The club football at RPL Leichhardt. And she'll be eager to impress, and no doubt been given clear instruction from Van Egmond. Newcastle, you can imagine, just looking to control things out for the remainder of this game. About 13 minutes of regulation time remaining, and then whatever we see into stoppage of, which will have to be a few, with we saw the injury to Heyman go down for a few minutes, substitutions as well. Clough asking the question for a bit of support, picked up well by Allen. Nicely done from Milivojevic, and Pryor had close attention with Nathan just over her shoulder. The Newcastle Jets, they can look to push forward. Sizing up options for the ball into the box. Here's Gooch. Just trying to pick the right time. Van Egmond. Dances out of danger. Wilson. She has a little bit more time and space. Finds the run of Davis. Clever run too. Murray, close attention. Whipped away kindly by Cannon Clough. What was a good ball in from Davis?
It wasn't. Cannon Clough has been positioned so well for all of this game in terms of protecting that central goal zone. She's made an enormous amount of interceptions purely based on good positioning and protecting that central goal zone area in this Canberra United back line.
A couple of changes now for Negos Popovic. Mary Stanich Floody, after a really solid performance, coming off and being replaced by Devon Jackson. And two, we saw Holly Murray making way, and it's a debut this afternoon, and a congratulations to Hannah McNulty, who's just taken to the field as well.
Yeah, and it's great to see Hannah McNulty out there. She's been around the NPL scene for a long time. She's had good success at those levels. So really looking forward to seeing how she fits into the Liberty A-League women's setup.
Well, a 24-year-old, spent a number of years with the Northern Tigers in the New South Wales NPL. And like you mentioned, a known goal scorer. So great to see her get her Liberty A-League debut and to see what she can produce on this stage. Mackenzie, she looks to go long, but has just taken a little slip there. Newcastle will want to capitalise. Nice ball through the lines. Lauren Allen, well, she is rapid, driving through on goal. Gets the shot away, and it's in the back of the net. Lauren Allen with a top-stanch finish. A beautiful strike separates the lead here at McKellar Park. And Newcastle, well, they're all but flying home.
Yeah, and once again, Canberra United backline, Emma Ilioski caught ball watching there, allows Allen to get off the shoulder. It's a great weighted pass in and a really good finish by Allen.
Well, it's cleared out the cobwebs. Nothing Chloe Lincoln could have done on that occasion. A really well-taken finish by Lauren Allen, who works tirelessly for the Jets. Does so much work up and down the flank, and great to see her rewarded with what is a top-class finish.
And at a critical moment in the game for the Newcastle Jets. They needed that extra goal just to close this game out, relieve a little bit of the pressure, and put that buffer in with the remaining minutes.
Well and truly to relieve the pressure as minutes tick away. That two-goal buffer is just what Van Egmond's side would have needed. And Flannery, well, she's looking for a response and a quick one at that for Canberra United. Defended well by Newcastle. Nice touch from Bolden. She'll slow things down. Lovely cross-field ball to Sophie Hoban. She looks to connect with Gooch. A little bit of miscommunication there at the back for Canberra. Some nervy moments. So we tick over into the last 10 minutes of regulation time. It's Van Egmond up against a former teammate in Cannon Clough. Van Egmond again. Supporting run from Karapetis, but the pass asking a little too much of Lorena Bauman. Well, Canberra will need to move things along should they look for a response here, and that's a really awkward fall. Karapetis, heavy knock. She's up to her feet, which is great to see, but she did land really heavily from that challenge.
She did, and it's the right decision by her teammates here just to instruct Karapetis just to take a breather and seek some medical attention. She's a young player. It's a head collision, so we're certainly hoping that she's okay.
Well, none too impressed from the contact from Christofferson, but these ones do have to be checked and care has to be taken in these moments. Just upended from that contact. I don't think she knew too much about the oncoming Christofferson.
No, and she's a brave player, and she's just landed awkwardly in that moment.
Of course, I don't like to see any player injured or hurt. She looks to be okay. She's one of the young Matildas travelling to China tomorrow with the squad. So good to see her back to her feet. The play gets underway again here for Canberra, and Clough can drive forward. McNulty helps on. Handy ball, but dealt well with by Pryor. Bauman, long searching ball. Nice touches from Van Egmond. We expect no different. Gooch, that one a little too much pepper behind it. Well, I mentioned earlier on that only three times in competition history have Newcastle beaten Canberra United. 17 times the reverse fixture, Canberra have got the win.
And I think, Grace, if this result is to stand, what an occasion, given that it is also being played at McKellar Park, and we all know how hard it is to go to McKellar and walk away with points.
Well, of those three times that Newcastle have beaten Canberra in history, just one of them at McKellar Park. It's a hard place to travel to, opposing teams know. But Canberra are still going to push for a response. Nathan, little glance up. Searching for a green shirt. Jackson. Lioski. Low driven ball in. Jackson again, all the way back to McKenzie. Nice diagonal ball from McKenzie, and Lioski can look up. Neat touch inside. Nice near post ball from Lioski. Flannery knows, frustrated with her effort there. It was good build-up from Canberra.
Yeah, it was an excellent little sequence of combination play on this left-hand side. Really well done by Ilioski to slip the little reverse ball in. It's a great run by Flannery. She's just outside that near post and slightly off balance when executing that shot.
Tough angle to get the shot away from. And much to the relief of Izzy Nino. That one sailing past the near post. Canberra still on the attack, but Nino will pick up again. She's sending her players forward, telling them to go long. Clough drops to McNulty. Grove looking for the run of Christofferson, but a Newcastle throw in, and Bauman. She'll take as long as she can. You can hear the shouts imploring Ruby Nathan to apply the pressure to hurry things up. Fanino forces the mistake back, and Canberra look to make something of it, but the pass lets them down. Here's Serena Bolden. She's driving to the corner. You can hear the shouts. McKenzie, strong player as well herself. Oh, Canberra will take the goal kick here. As Newcastle look to line up another couple of changes for the afternoon, and it will be Zoe Karapetis who makes way for Alex Hun, good experienced defender, just to come in and settle the game. And Karapetis, what was a really solid performance for the afternoon. And it will be as well Lara Gooch making way for Mindy J. Barbieri. She's got great goal scoring prowess herself.
Yeah, and I think definitely a solid shift for all the younger players that have been involved both sides today, Grace. We've seen a lot of minutes from some U20, U23 players, which is exactly what we want to see, those exposures.
Well said. Good young talent on show today. Just confirmation of those subs. There's the experienced Alex Hun coming on for the youngster in Zoe Karapetis. And Mindy Barbieri taking place of Lara Gooch, who too had a productive afternoon.
And what a fantastic addition in terms of to bring that experience on in Barbieri and Alex on number of A-League minutes and years for both of them. And they can just steady this ship and hopefully see out this result for Newcastle Jets.
Well, here's Alex Hun being tested for the first time since coming on. It's a heavy clash with Ruby Nathan. A no-nonsense defender is Alex Hun, but experienced, calm at the bat. Jackson connects with Christofferson and back to Grove. Now Clough edges a pass away to McKenzie. Good ball over top to Ilioski. She needs to get across in time, not on the side of Canberra United. Milivojevic looking for another moment of magic, and it is in the back of the net. Vesna Milivojevic in the dying stages of this game. It's fumbled into the net from Izzy Nino, but Milivojevic, she won't complain. She's got two for the day.
No, and that has Milivojevic written all over it. In terms of the pressure applied at the top of the box, needed to be closed down. The goalkeeping, for me, that's easy pickings by Nino. She has to do better in that moment.
Yeah, no doubt. Izzy Nino will be disappointed with that effort. Good pace behind the strike from Milivojevic. And perhaps she's breathed just a bit of life, a bit of hope back into this Canberra United side. Closes down the buffer just to one goal. Well, Vesna Milivojevic, 5 goals in 4 games. Serena Bolden looking to produce at the other end. Here's Davis. It's going to sail out for what will be a Newcastle corner.
Yeah, and I dare say EVE will be in any rush to take this corner right now, Grace.
We tick over into stoppage time. Of which there will be 7 minutes, so plenty of time remaining. Christofferson finally goes and closes down after the shouts from Chloe Lincoln were finally heeded. Plenty of time remaining. It will be a long 7 minutes for Gary Van Egmond, but for Canberra United, there's still opportunity here.
There definitely is. If they can get out of this back third, we can see that potentially they can create some chances. There's enough time here for Canberra United to jag one.
Well, we've seen how quickly both sides can respond in any given moment. And here's Ruby Nathan striding out, an industrial challenge from Alex Hun.
Great challenge by Alex Hun. It's the timing, the area of the field, really good defending.
Well, her timing is impeccable. Alex Hun going to ground in those moments. Not afraid of a slide challenge. Well, Ruby Nathan receiving a fair bit of attention. That's a really tidy turn from Ilioski. Needs to get herself away from danger, and she will finally get a free kick. Serena Bolden, a quick hand of apology.
And that's not a bad foul by Bolden. It eats up a bit of time. It slows down the momentum.
Milivojevic, meanwhile, looks to help on for Flannery, but it's dealt well with by Newcastle, who at the moment are absorbing. Here's Nicky Flannery. The assistant referee has deemed a free kick has been awarded. Flannery up against Lorena Bauman, who has also been tireless this afternoon for the Newcastle Jets. Oh, Negos Popovic looking pensively on as we tick away through half time of this stoppage time. 3.5 minutes have elapsed of the 7. Clearance is a little short. Canberra still with some work to do, but still with some time to do it. Here's Grove. That's glanced on. Christofferson, what can she produce in these dying moments? The pass just escapes Flannery. Newcastle. Well, they won't want to go to goal. They'll just look to eat away at these last minutes in front of a crowd of 1,853 today at McKellar Park. But it may still be another opportunity as Serena Bolden hooks her foot around that shot.
It's actually a really nice, well-worked action by Newcastle Jets there in terms of getting numbers around the ball and creating a half chance there for Bolden.
Caitlin Williams says nothing of it as Newcastle can look to drive forward again. Just over 2 minutes of stoppage time remaining. The Jets will go to the corner and just really try and slow things down. Canberra, well, they need to apply the pressure and try and get things back up the other end. It's a Newcastle throw. And in all her experience, Matilda Emily Van Egmond coming back from winning a shield with San Diego Wave in the NWSL, she will take as long as she needs.
She will, and I'd be surprised if she doesn't try and keep it in that corner for longer periods of time.
And Chloe Lincoln, well, she'll look to get this back up the other end as soon as she can. 90 seconds of play remain. McKenzie. Long sweeping ball. Tracked really well by Josie Wilson. Flannery frustrated. Well, McKellar Park has been known to produce some pretty high scoring games, and today is no exception as we tick over to the final 60 seconds of stoppage time. And Newcastle, with just a bit of momentum, managing out this game really well. Clough. Bit of an awkward one for Lincoln, and McKenzie can only do so much as help on. That's fallen to Bauman. Van Egmond so good at dictating the pace of a game. That pass a little short. Just 30 seconds remaining. Clough leaves the ball for Lincoln. And you'd have to think this would be one last attacking play for Canberra United to try and level things up. Nodded away by Pryor. She's been solid this afternoon. It's Jackson. Clough helps on as Caitlin Williams calls time on this one this afternoon. At McKellar Park in what was a goal fest between Canberra United and the Newcastle Jets. A dominant performance from Gary Van Egmond's side, and it gets the Jets back to winning ways as they pocket all 3 points in what will be a happy trip back to Newcastle. We finish here this afternoon at McKellar Park. Canberra United 3, Newcastle Jets 4. And, well, it was well and truly end-to-end. It started early and it went late, and it was Michelle Heyman who got the scoring underway for Canberra United today.
Yeah, some very clinical finishes out there today by some of our more star players of the Liberty A-League in terms of Michelle Heyman and Serena Bolden, as well as we can see, EVE's attempt with Milivojevic. Again, it took a deflection, but if you don't shoot, you don't score. So great that this player has that confidence in the front third.
Well, it's one thing Canberra have proved they can do is score goals, but at the other end, well, Serena Bolden in her first game in a Newcastle shirt, well, she scored a brace today, levelling things up on two occasions for the Jets, and you've got to say a very good signing by Gary Van Egmond.
And again, Milivojevic, she just takes the opportunity when she has space. Essentially, poor goalkeeping by Nino in this moment.
And it gave just a moment's hope for Canberra United and for the fans as Emily Van Egmond takes a well-deserved rest on the bench this afternoon in what was another really solid performance by the Matilda back in the Liberty A-League. Another goal as well to her name. As we have a little look at the full-time match stats, Leah Blaney again, nothing much separating the sides in the way of possession or shots, but it was just those moments of clinical finishing that got the Newcastle Jets the win today.
Spot on, Grace. Clinical finishing by the Jets and a well-deserved win.
Oh, thanks very much for your company this afternoon. Don't forget, all the weekend's action will be covered on Dubzone tonight, live on 10 Play at 8:30 p.m. On behalf of the whole crew here, Leah Blaney and myself, Grace Gill, thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week.